are having so much fun, and we know you're going to love our next guest. His name is Tony Walker, and he is a comedy guy. Comedy cures everything. So.
Absolutely. I had cancer at the age of 32, and I do believe that the laughter and the positive attitude got me through it just as much as the medications did, which led to the comedy troupe that I run called Knockem Dead Comedy. We do dinner theater, murder mysteries, game shows, kid shows. You know, we're not stand-up or anything like that, just comedy shows, variety shows.
Do you go to restaurants and where else, like theaters?
Restaurants, private parties, corporate events, fundraisers. Did I say fundraisers?
Fundraisers, firehouse.
Comedy shows, they're murder mysteries, they're audience participation. It's a scripted show because, you know, there's clues and hints that have to go out, but it's not a don't blink or you'll miss something. It's not Agatha Christie. You know,
right.
It's just, it's a comedy, it's lighthearted, but one of the characters does get killed,
right.
And then the audience has to
get
figure out who did
it
is. And why. And if it's a private party or a corporate event, we personalize it. To fit, you know, their event.
Now, do you ask the audience for help for them with the mysteries?
Or yeah, they solve it.
All by themselves.
Based on what they saw during the show, we even give them a little section where they can interrogate the suspects.
Oh, that's
and,
fun.
You know, so we'll deflect, deny, point fingers at other characters, but everybody makes the rounds throughout the whole room.
Okay.
And talks to people.
The show is guaranteed. It's 100% guaranteed fun.
Totally.
Everywhere
yeah,
we go,
always.
Everybody loves that show.
The audience they just get so involved, and they're just such a part of the show, and that makes it even better.
Other things that you do aside
yeah,
from mystery.
Yeah, we do game shows.
Oh, the game show, we have a podium with lights and buzzers and sounds, and it's basically
like
a trivia game show. Or it
right.
could be, you know, again, we ad-lib with that too. So they may want a trivia game show, but if we show up and they're a loud, boisterous group and they're a lot of fun, we could ask them to do funny physical challenges or do some karaoke or whatever, or name that tune, whatever we feel like doing,
oh,
and they'll be willing to do, we'll take it there.
Yeah.
What movie introduced the phrase, there's no crying in baseball?
Oh, wait.
What letter comes after A?
No.
B is correct!
Is there a favorite skit that you do that just still cracks you up every time you do it?
We do a lot of audience participation murder mystery shows, comedic murder mystery shows. And there's two shows. We have a mob show. We're in New York. You have to have the mob shows. And we have a redneck wedding, which is just...
Oh, that I have to come see that one.
You're welcome
yeah.
anytime. In fact, I even
well,
brought you a shirt.
Well, growing up in St. Louis, Missouri, I have to say you did.
Oh, of course I did.
Hey.
That you will wear everywhere you go. In fact, I have a whole bunch there. I'm giving one out to everybody.
Everywhere
here.
I go. Okay.
That's right.
There you go.
Knockem Dead
oh,
Comedy.
Oh, that's call. Great.
Can
Knockem
I pretend
Dead
I'm
comedy.
Drinking something?
Excellent. Yeah, okay. You can pretend like
thanks,
you're drinking something.
I'm having fun on the set.
You know, we actually do put water in it when people, when guests ask,
just
we
not
do. But
this
if you,
guest.
But if you don't ask ahead of time, wait, this one's full of water. You ready?
Nice.
All right, there you go.
Johnny, you have a good time tonight or what?
Had an awesome time.
All right.
KDC,
that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, all right.
Okay, we'll just do that for right now.
Hey, how do you say there, people? It's Johnny Brennan, creator of The Jerky Boys, also of Fox TV's Family Guy fame. I just want to let you know you're listening to Tony and Sally on the Knockem Dead radio show. They're going to keep knocking them dead, so keep listening, you wacky sons of bitch. Right there. Over and out there, sweet Charlie.
3-2 to Mookie Wilson. Little roller up along first. Behind the back! It gets through Buckner! Here comes Knight, and the Mets win it!
Hello, Tony. Mookie Wilson here, 1986 Mets. How you doing? Long time no see, man. Hey, man, I miss you guys, man, at Knockem Dead Comedy Radio, man. I miss you. I wish I was still up there, man. But I'll wait till it warms up a little bit, and hopefully this year things will be a little bit better, man. But when you have, we're talking about comedy, hey, the early years of Mets was a lot to laugh about. You had to make a lot of comedy off those guys. Hey, hope to see you guys during the summer, and hopefully get back on the show, man, at some point in time during the course of the year, all right? All right? Yeah, fine. Contact me, man. All right, Tony. Talk to you later.
The Knockem Dead Comedy Radio Show, also brought to you by Two Eagles Auto Body. For more than 25 years, Two Eagles Auto Body has been the leader in auto body repairs and customer satisfaction on Long Island. Two Eagles Auto Body handles every type of auto repair, from custom applications and restorations to repairs involving insurance claims. So call Two Eagles Auto Body and ask for John Rossi at 516-328-2527.
Okay, hi everybody. Nice to see you. Hope everybody is well. Welcome to the Knockem Dead Comedy Podcast. It is Friday, September 23rd. Andy's here. And we are awaiting the arrival of Kris Thomas, who I do believe she said she's coming around 11:30. Kris Thomas,
photographer extraordinaire. Neat. And very hot. And just a good friend. And her family are good friends. Her brother was one of my best friends ever. So it's gonna be a fun show today. You, what? What's so funny?
No, because just like all the heavy shit. That's my favorite. It's one of my favorite things. All the heavy shit that's not for air.
Oh,
and then right into we're the monkeys in the cage.
It's the Muppet Show. Yay! We.
It is gonna be fucking hilarious. Awesome.
Yes. Absolutely. But that's actually one of the things I like about coming in here. I've said it a lot because we don't get really paid, but it's the relationships that have developed that I enjoy when we come in here. And
likewise, I like coming in here because then I don't have to clean it up. Usually it's whole production. You guys seem to enjoy it.
It's who we are.
It's who we are.
But this, in my opinion, well, all right. So the other day, we haven't done a show since Tuesday. That was the last time in here because Wednesday we're off, and then yesterday I had a funeral to go to, but which I want to get to more about the funeral later. So the last time we were in here on Tuesday, I was very concerned about you because you were going on a trip this weekend. But on Tuesday, there was talk about mushrooms, and plus the people that you're going with. I really thought today I'd be saying goodbye to you. You
might still be. That's a long drive.
But it won't be.
Lions, maybe? I don't know.
Mountain lions.
Are there mountain lions upstate?
There's dinosaurs. Probably. Pterodactyls.
I'm hoping that the Creation Museum, we're going to be close to that. Or is that in Tennessee? I can't remember. Obviously, it doesn't matter.
I figured you could pass away, not from a car accident, from a long drive, but just because of who you're going with and mushrooms.
And all of that absolutely could still happen.
Right. Why don't we see the chat on there?
Maybe because Ken said something a while back and there hasn't been.
I can see the chat. You can see it on the side there, but in that little chat box thing that it's not showing. There's nothing going on in that box.
Yeah, let's fire some stuff up into that box.
How do we get?
See what happens.
How do we get things on that box? How do we fill the box?
Things in the box. On the box, that's a different fetish. My kink is in the box.
That's weird. I wonder why that's.
I bet you there's a button.
Yeah, there's definitely. Let's see.
Chat.
No, that didn't seem to do anything.
No, it didn't.
This is new software we're using, and this is my first day of using this software by myself. And I've caught myself making a ton of mistakes.
There was nobody there. Nobody was watching. That's a Green Day song. On Dookie, the album Dookie. If you just let it play, because you're too stoned to stop it. At the very, I don't know. I can't even remember how long it was. Or you had to skip a bunch of tracks. Remember with CDs, they would hide something. You'd put it in and you'd be like, there's 80 tracks on this.
Right. Yeah.
But there's only 10 songs listed.
Yep.
And you go through and then I imagine this would be a Tony Walker move of being like, wait a second. And until you got to something, or until there was nothing, you go, I feel like I was used.
No. I've talked about it a million times. I'm a big CD guy. I will actually play the whole thing. So even if there's nothing, I'll let it play because just in case they're doing I want to hear, I want to get their creative. I want to feel what they were they were thinking. So I want to I'm trying to figure out why there's all this silence.
Right.
Or maybe a minute in, all of a sudden there'll be something.
Right.
So I'll play a full album at least once, even if there is a lot of wasted.
Do you feel violated if there's nothing?
I am that was wasted freaking time. Queen, the last
dead.
Well,
still.
Yeah. When Freddie died,
him too.
He was he was working on some new material. He recorded. They wrote some songs. He wrote. So after he died, they finished these tracks up, and they put out an album.
Right.
At the end of the album, when the last song is finished, there's almost 20 minutes of just like a synthesizer going, and it like 20 minutes. Oh. And at the very end, you hear, no, you just hear a quick, yeah, and that's it.
Oh, cool.
But the first time I got the album, I didn't know, so I'm playing it. You know, after 5 minutes, it's like, oh, wait a minute, what is going on here? And then,
right.
But you keep on listening because you want to hear if there's a little something going on. Or,
right.
So, I'm 19 minutes, I'm like, what the hell is going on? And then finally it ends. So a part of you is mad, but at the same time, part of you is glad it's over. And then you can tell all the other geeks like myself,
that's
like I heard it.
Sex is when you, oh, thank God it's over.
Yes. Right. What is Ken Pichel talking about? Morning, kids. Stay gold, Andy, wherever you are. Saying hi, then a meeting, then I'll be back. All right. Stay gold, Andy.
I did play. Well, I was supposed to play Johnny in the group home I lived in.
The Outsiders?
It was The Outsiders. I was supposed to be Johnny. It was a tool for Johnny.
Did Ken Pichel know this?
He might have. I mean, it's something I've said before, but only once or twice. But Ken is a super fan.
He is. Oh, you know what? I might have figured out this chat thing. I think.
Oh, snap.
Because I think you only see what's in the chat box after you join in.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
Oh, you see it? Well.
Yeah, there's something there now.
Oh, it is. Okay.
It must be just outside of the,
yes,
the screen.
Well, no, this is on the delay, so we'll.
Oh.
All right. So I didn't do anything wrong. Yay for me.
Just don't fuck up. Just don't fuck up. Nice.
Cool. So are you looking forward to this trip?
I'm super looking forward to this trip. I'm super psyched. I can tell my wife is super angry at me that I'm, because she does like everything. So she's just like always with the kids and whatnot. And I'm sort of like I do kind of play Uncle Dad a little bit.
Really? I don't get that impression at all.
Well, the thing is like they get home from school and they're like, hey, Dad, could we, they finish our homework and they'll be like, can we go on our devices? And I'm like, yeah, go ahead. Because you've been in school all day. Go do something mindless that you want to do.
Yep.
Like that part's over.
Right.
And then I make dinner and that's when we all have to hang out.
When do they do their homework?
After school.
So school, homework, then devices.
That's, I think of things of like almost like on a game board, like the way you complete your move is by finishing everything.
Okay.
So your school move, which has been 6 hours long, is not completed until you've done your homework. And that actually comes from me. I never did my homework.
Yeah, me too.
Full fucking stop. Yep. Never did my homework.
Hated it.
Was completely socially promoted through all of, and my ability to take tests, between social promotion and ability to take tests and cult of personality. There were teachers that just liked me.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I've been there.
I did none of the work. I did not deserve. I don't deserve my local diploma from Comswag High School. Not even a Regents, because I bailed. Because I've taken like 4 AP classes. This is before AP became.
Back then they were the honors classes.
Well, they were AP. They were AP, but it was. It was because I didn't have my mother. We didn't have a lot of money, and then like I wanted to take these classes, and everybody because I was interested.
Yeah, sure.
Not for any other reason. Oh, was that her?
That was Kris Thomas. I guess she's going to the girls'
beautiful room.
Beautiful
hair. Yeah. But I wanted to learn. I just wanted to learn. I really didn't care about grades. I wanted to be in lecture. College. I loved being in lecture. I loved having conversations about things. I didn't care about taking tests or writing papers. Sometimes,
agreed.
At some point, eventually, I did get to the point where I'm like, oh, I actually enjoy writing papers, but I enjoy being at Stony Brook, being at the library.
Depends on the topic.
You
would just go with writing papers.
What I like is. Because it's about expressing your opinion in a way that convinces somebody that either they should have that opinion or that you have a valid opinion. And to me, that's actually kind of like a fascinating thing. I was just having a conversation with my daughters last night. It was Family Connect night. Our district does this thing. No homework on Family Connect night.
Oh.
District-wide.
Okay.
And everybody's just supposed to play a game or whatever. But my wife was working late. We had dinner. And we were sitting there. And one of them was complaining about how teachers who say, when you ask, can I go to the bathroom? They say, may I go to the bathroom?
Right.
And I gave them the argument as to... the next time this happens, they have the green light from me anyway.
Yeah.
To go, great that you want me to be more formal, but can I go to the bathroom? Isn't the action.
Right.
The action is going.
Yes.
Hello.
Hi, Kris Thomas.
Sneak in. Hi.
Hello. That was like a really like glamorous, like
that's she is
turn around.
She's all glamour, baby.
Always glamorous. What was Where's Sally? Not that you're come not on. Lovely.
Have you guys never met?
How not in person.
Andy, Kris, Thomas. Andy.
Andy. Yeah, we've dallied on the chats and messages
these
of
verbs you're whipping
yeah,
out.
Yeah, dally. Yeah.
Well, just big if you words. Like whipping out, just hold on. Stick around.
Wait, should I put what do
you don't have to put those
no,
on.
Don't okay, put them cool. on.
Is it, what is your first time here? Come on, what?
I think I always put them on.
Do you? You don't have to, unless somebody calls, but you don't have to.
We are the world.
That's what I was
saying.
Thinking. All so, right, I like you already, Andy Plagino.
Andy is fantastic, and you are too, so I'm thrilled that you're here.
I can't see what I look like, though. Might look like shit.
There you go.
That's impossible.
No. I have a lot of shellacked it on today.
Stop it.
I did. Look, you could scratch your name in my face.
All right.
Well,
all
I had other thoughts. But so we were talking about... homework. Oh, I just killed it. Oh, I thought I killed
him.
I got him.
Now he's dead.
Wow. Where'd that come from? Yeah, it's weirdness today. We were actually just talking about homework, and I'm continuing this because I have a question for you. I just want to add in, I was always against homework. First of all, because I just didn't want to do it. But even as an adult, I just feel the kids are in school long enough. Now they have to take it home and do more. Like, some people have a job where they take some stuff home with them. Most people, I think it's safe to say most people don't. So why do the kids have to then, you know,
they've actually
then have
done
to do
studies
it?
Where, like, not until eighth grade does it make a difference. And not
oh, is that right?
much of one.
But in my opinion, study hall should be held in, like, the cafeteria or the gym where a bunch of teachers can come in and kids can then go to whatever subject they teach and go over whatever they need to go over.
Right, that's gay.
And, well, yeah, but it's better than homework. But how this ties into you, Kris Thomas, is because I just saw the news report where your daughter was interviewed.
Oh, neat.
And
so you know, like, where the go-to, like, News 12 needs, like, a middle-aged mom that's angry about the water situation. They're like, Kris.
Oh, well, okay. Believe me, I know how your daughter got on News 12. That I don't need to ask. But because you...
She's actually... Okay. I'll go into her relationships. They have their own fantastic relationship.
Oh, is that right?
It's so... It's kind of adorable.
Well...
number one, that was really about mental health.
Right. That's where I was going with this. So it's your school district was saying there should be... Kids should be able to take a day off from school for mental health time.
I think acknowledging mental health is really important.
Hell yeah.
And I think that, like, just making it part, and I hate to sound like part of the narrative, like, it should be legitimized just like COVID or...
Sure.
For sure. I mean...
Well, hopefully not like COVID, because half the people still don't believe.
Yeah,
well,
true. Yeah.
Well, half people...
Like
there
breathing,
are people that
like
do
air.
Not, I know people that are mentally ill that are like, if you go to a therapist, you're a pussy. I'm like... you need to go to therapist.
Have you seen there's a great PSA of this guy who's bench pressing? And no, it's okay. It wants
I'm
to be
mom.
There.
I'm a mom.
Look, she even folded it for you.
I know, right? it's just like half starch. And the guy is like being crushed. And he's like, no, it's okay. Everybody in my family goes through this.
Yeah.
And it's like yes. Like it's like mental health. It's because it's been used by the proletariat.
Ooh.
No, again, I'm not gonna make this a rant, but it's been used over the years to get people to work. I think.
What
and
do you
to
mean?
And to just keep going. to be like, you know, like, I'm not doing well. Well, right. Just fight through it. Like,
yeah, so we have cops jumping off of bridges. That's great. And veterans blowing their brains out.
But luckily we live in such interesting times, as the Confucian curse goes, that we know enough that we need to take, like, we need to address it. It needs to be accepted. It
needs to.
Are we there yet? No.
No.
But we're having the conversation finally.
Yeah.
Instead of the, though I have my own problems with, like, the school social worker at my daughter's school. I mean, granted, she's deserves it a little bit, but just like the people who are protecting their own jobs, but it's those people that are also taking away from the narrative of mental health being important.
Yeah. I think that there are, you just got to find people that, like, my daughter's school has a fantastic nurse, and she'll be like, if you need to chill out, you just come in here. She really has treated my daughter for mental health as much as physical health, if not more. And my daughter's guidance counselor is awesome too. I also will just sign my kid out of school. I will also, by the way, in conjunction, my daughter sees a therapist. Very candidly, she's on medication. We give her whatever she needs. I have pulled her out of school for mental health day unapologetically, but we don't just say, like, oh, mental health day, sit around and play video games. Like,
right,
we
right.
work on things on a day-to-day basis in our house, like gratitude journal. And just like I talk about her health in general, her diet, we talk about, like, she just got nominated for, God, it's so not like me. Homecoming court.
Nice.
Really?
Well, because it's just a thing, like, you know.
It perpetuates this caste system that we all hate at high school, but then we perpetuate it. Like, yeah.
But I feel like the kids are so much better now of picking better people.
It's just, that's like good for her, but not, it's just being part of the machine. And I feel like homecoming in and of itself, the fact that we're like, all come out for the football game. It's like, well, what about the Lego League team, like the robotics team? Do we have a homecoming celebration for them? Right. Does the mascot come to them? And I feel like she's happy. I had to sit her down, like, very, I had to be, you know, I'm a little hard, like, I say what I mean. And I, instead of just laying into this caste system machine, like, you can't just be, like, against the machine when it's not working for you. Like, you can't be like the white person at apartheid, like, no, this is okay, I feel good about it. Like, yeah, of course you do. Like, so if you're voted for, like, homecoming court, you can't be like, nah, it's cool. But, like, when you are dumped pig blood is on you, then it's a problem. Like, don't be part of the machine. And I would just assume she'd be like...
Well, here's the problem. And my grandfather, I've always been very rebellious. Like, I will cut off my nose to spite my face.
Yeah, me too.
Like,
I love it.
Down with all forms of... like, regularity. My grandfather, though, once told me he had just had a heart attack, and I'm they're all out in the hallway talking. I'm sitting on the bed with him in the hospital, and he goes, I heard you got in trouble again. I'm like, yeah, well, and I explained why I had, and he goes, listen, the system doesn't change by you just bucking it. The system changes by you becoming part of it and changing it.
Okay.
So what in my opinion is that we do things like homecoming and whatnot, and if you're the kind of person who feels like it's like I unfairly got this in a way because, like, I'm pretty or whatever, is then you can then speak out about it and actually write an article for the school newspaper or a blog post, or every time you talk to people say, listen, I think so and so because these are the things I admire about them. Like, use the bully pulpit, if you will, for positivity and the advancement of taking down everything.
I just think idea of, like, taking some students and putting them on a pedestal.
Well, some students are always going to be on a pedestal, and it's arbitrary. I go my Three Village is my kid's school district, and they are very good about acknowledging everybody, because, to be honest, the thing we're most known for, aside from lacrosse, is the academics. Like, it's a phenomenally, it just got, we just got recognized by some sort of
I recognize you anyway.
I think you got a blue ribbon.
Blue ribbon, that's it.
I'm on it.
And It's very involved.
Little stalkers.
Yeah. Hey, Tony, why don't you go kick bricks? Chris and I are going to have a conversation about school districts on Long Island. Really, really deep. Yes. But anyway, yeah. No, it's but I like. I truly like.
They you have farming in Mattituck.
Yeah, all the way.
Wow.
I used to work at Harb's. I was the
really
the orchard one.
Oh.
I drove the tractor on the hayride. I gave a tour of the because a friend of mine married into the family, but. Love out there, but I'm not that far. I'm east of Talkit.
Well, yeah, and well, you have your house in Kachok.
Kachok? It sounds so dirty.
Does it? It's so lovely.
Yeah, Kachok. Like, think about it. Call somebody a Kachok sometime.
They knew they'd be like,
"You're a Setauket." That doesn't sound like anything. You're a Floral Park.
Ugh.
Right.
Oh, sorry. I love Floral.
Well, that was actually one of the things I wanted to talk to you about. Like. I'm not sure how you would even know if you like or hate Floral Park because you're like I don't
hate Floral Park,
but you're out and about more than anybody.
I'm moving target is hard to hit. Yeah, I don't even post a lot of what I do because I think sometimes people are like, really, another concert, really. Yeah, I do a lot. I was at, you know where I was last night? Nope. I saw Mick Thomas last night.
Oh, cool. No,
Mick Thomas is hilarious.
Yeah.
There's no way we're not related. I would like to have him in here and have him do the DNA, because I'm on Ancestry.
Oh.
In here? Do the DNA in here?
I will bring a kit.
All right.
There's a probe involved now. He was great.
That's fine.
So my son
yesterday
was like, I want to see this guy, Dimitri Martin.
That's on my list. Who is that? I don't even know who that is.
I met Dimitri Martin in like 2003 or 4 when I was doing improv at Upright Citizens Brigade. And it was Saturday night. They have a show called Ass Cat. And that's what I met Amy Poehler, Dimitri Martin. Usually those are the two that I draw name drops that
really?
I use. Yeah. And Dimitri Martin, first of all, being Greek, he is sort of like probably one of him, Zach Galifianakis. Those are probably the two funniest
Galifianakis
Greek comics of all time.
Oh my god, he's so funny.
Which I saw Zach out at Sag Harbor years ago, the summer Hangover hit, so it was not sold out or anything, which was funny. But now, if he were to go there, it would be absolutely mobbed. But Dimitri Martin, he's kind of like what would have been alt comedy in the early 2000s, where he had like a big pad of paper.
Yeah, he had that last night. That was actually one of the best parts of it.
I love Dimitri.
Where'd you see him?
The Paramount.
Oh. And so he's popular now with the youngsters?
Place was packed.
Really?
The kids love him. So my son went because his buddy was down the aisle and you could only buy two tickets. I was going to send him with the other father, but you could only buy two packs. Packed. But it was like an, you know, unusual crowd. Like, you know, you could tell it was like the Freaks and Geeks. As one of the Freaks and Geeks, it was like the Freaks and Geeks. But, yeah, he was all right. But Mick, you know, he's funny.
Yeah, Mick is great.
He was like a little dicey with my kid there talking about, you know, crazy sex. But that's okay.
Well, which kid did you bring?
Miles, the youngest.
How old is he?
15. He's almost 15.
So, yeah, that's a little.
Goddamn test, Andy Pajano. I'm three.
There's an S at the end.
Little Janos.
You sound like this black friend I had in high school who his name was Jamal Woods.
That's me.
And he would go, "Yo, what's up, Andy Pajano?" And I'd be like, "What's up, Jamal Wood?" And he'd be like, "It's Jamal Woods." And I'm like, "It's Andy Plajanos."
You taught him.
Yeah, I showed him. See, it's just like Dangerous Minds.
Speaking of comedy, I have to kind of like eat my hat, if that's the term. I come in hat in hand to Governor's Radio in that years ago, I don't know if you want me to name this comic or not, I really laid into the comic.
You really what?
I thought
laid
it was awful. I was like, who let this woman on stage?
And it was in the main room?
Correct. And then I have to say that I now come hat in hand that I give her a lot of credit that years later, she has worked. She has put in the work, which I love the craft of comedy.
Sure.
And have seen it with this one. And I saw her the other night. I was here for, I don't even know his name's Cannon.
Mike Cannon. Yeah. Mike Cannon. He's great.
Oh, you were here. That was Saturday night. It was Saturday night a week ago, Saturday night. Because the patio, I was watching the patio because Fat Jay was featured on that didn't he?
No. He might have been in the giggle room, though, because Ziggler was in the giggle room, which I was torn. Which way do I go?
Oh, no.
Which
this way was do the I week go? Before that, I want to say.
Yeah, I was there. And
because Kenny got the what do you call it? The soap opera stars. Ended up going in there. They kicked to Ken in there, no. And McNeely got called, kicked to the patio.
So. No, it wasn't that. There was no patio. There was giggle room because they moved Ziegler. Is it Ziegler?
Ziegler. Yeah. John Ziegler. Yep.
I hung up on pronunciation.
Obviously.
And I was like, it was like so hard to who do we want to go? This guy I've never seen or this. So anyway, do you want me to name who it is?
Well, all right, before you do that.
Yeah.
So you tell me more. So you saw her years back and what you actually.
I called in here and I was like, that. F woman does not who put her on stage. I will never get that.
All right. Now I remember that.
And then I have to say, I have seen her since several times, and she's been improved. She's working it right. We're never
Jeff
gonna be
Bosey.
It's a female.
Jeff Bosey. I'm not changing my answer.
And she listen. I don't think she's selling at MSG, but I give people credit for
working. Okay, who is it? Because this is a positive. Yeah, absolutely.
You want to guess?
Yeah, I know. I was actually running names.
You don't know who it is?
I don't remember who
it is. I mean, who's a female that's an opener here every night?
Olga?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's come a long way, right?
Yes, she has.
She's a very good
comic. She really has.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Her shtick is like her shtick. The dentist blowjob joke. I laugh every time. And usually when it's like a repeat, I'm like, I don't. Like even I, yeah, but she... Olga, you probably don't even want... You come a long way, baby.
Sorry, she's not watching.
She's not? No.
You could have said my mother. You could have said my
mother.
Your
mother's hilarious. No, I love her blowjob joke.
It's not a good blowjob joke. No, it's not. She needs to work on it. I've told her a million times.
I have to say, I have to give credit where credit's due. I very, very rarely apologize. I'm German and Irish. And, yeah, she has, you know, some of these people, you know, I get it. It's not easy. I'm a critic that sits her ass in the stands and doesn't get up on stage, which is such a hypocrite.
Why don't you get up on stage?
You know, I've been thinking about it, but
you
I don't
should.
Have balls.
Really?
Every now and then I'm like, this would be a good shtick. Like, my brother's like, yeah, that little thing you do about that. Like, I have a whole bobbing for apples thing I do.
Oh.
And a whole... like a few things that I do.
You know what you do?
Nude beaches, because I've been going to a lot of
all right, wait a minute. What?
Two nude beaches last week. Who knew?
Two new nude beaches? Or
nude, with a D.
Lots of dick. Yeah.
That's usually...
Here, right?
Yeah, oh. Yeah.
Are usually nude beaches are primarily dick.
Nope, titties.
Yeah.
Were you nude on this beach?
No. Oh. I know when to keep my clothes on. Like, that's the funny thing about it. So, I'm really out there for the... wildlife. There's been lots of whales on Long Island, so and I'm dying to see these off.
Oh,
yeah.
So you're talking about people?
Yeah, I thought you were talking about people on the
whales.
New beach.
And people are sending me videos, and I belong to a lot of Facebook pages that post these videos. And I'm like, I got to see these whales. So I go like on a Wednesday. I start walking east to Field 6, and then I'm like, that guy looks like. Okay. And I'm not like, listen, I've seen, I think you've all heard my Sanibel story with the guy's dick in my face.
Yes.
Unwavering. I've seen enough. I know what I'm in for. But it's just, God bless them. They just, dicks out. So then, the other day, I get very antsy, you can imagine. And I'm like, nobody would go hiking with me. And I'm like, I'm just going to go to this new... I like to look on maps and find green space. And then I either bike or drive there. So I went to this Fort Tilden.
Oh, yeah.
Brooklyn, yeah. I don't really know Brooklyn. I know that I'm an Irish daughter of a firefighter who has never been to Breezy Point. And why there's not protests about this, I can't believe. So I'm like, I'm going to go and I'm going to walk to Breezy. Because once I get there, they'll be like, oh, Shannon O'Malley, come on in. We're going to give you some, you know, corned beef and cabbage. And so I get to this Fort Till. I always like to find places to shoot to. Like, is this fort cool? Because, like, Fort Totten's pretty cool. And I start walking west. And, like, sure enough, like, 3 days later, I'm like, is that good? Is that maybe? No, maybe it's just European. It is Brooklyn. Like, he's just wearing a little Speedo. And the next guy... And then I'm like, nope, that's a dick. That is a dick. Right there, right next to Breezy.
Yeah, I feel bad for that first guy.
Why?
Because you're like not sure if his like that's.
Oh yeah, that's
small
that
mean, penis.
Yeah, that's like small. A, if you couldn't tell, yeah.
Yeah.
But
is
then,
he wearing a speedo? Not very hairy, I'm sure.
But then you did see a whale. You saw a Moby Dick.
Yes. Mm.
That's thank you, Fremder, for that. Thank you.
Chats up there.
Yeah, we. Little small improvements here and there.
Wow. Yeah. It is rough to see my own face, though. That's a little.
No, not for us.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
I had to zoom
best
in.
Best part of the day.
So, yeah, so she killed it. I thought she did well. And, yeah, I'm thinking about going tonight. You guys going tonight?
No. I will be in Walton, New York.
I'm sorry.
What, to see Craig Robinson tonight?
Yeah.
He's great. I wish I could be here. I'd love him. I would love to see him. I can't. I have something to do with my daughter. But
I'm trying to get my daughter in here.
What do you mean?
So she's
what,
17.
To work
like
here?
Emerson. No.
What do you mean? Comic?
She's 17, so it's 18 and older.
Oh, sorry. I misunderstood.
What's the, let me see what I can
older.
Do here.
You want to see what she looks like? I'm like,
No. I don't care what she looks like.
I'll sign a waiver. I'm like, Emerson, just ask all your friends. Someone's got to give you a license for one night. I'll drop it off. Is it terrible? Yeah. This is the apparent thing that goes on in my house, by the way.
No. It's about being backstage. It's not being front stage. What's the other show? Do you have it written or?
What, in the Giga Room? Yeah. No, I don't. I know that Craig Robinson's here. No, I don't know who's in the Giga Room tonight. Sorry.
I got it. It's all right.
But I know Craig Robinson and Liz Mealy and medium Robert Hanson and Tom Eshelman, they're all playing here this weekend.
Oh, yeah. No, this is not. Liz Mealy is in.
Liz Mealy's in the Giga Room?
Yeah.
I don't know her. Is she funny?
Yeah, she's funny.
Yeah.
She's been here before.
They have a, yeah.
Craig Robinson is one of those people that you don't know his name, but you know his face. So look him up.
He's
great.
He's
great. Yeah, that's going to be a good show. Let me see what I can do for you, Kris Thomas.
No. If it was a Butera show, I would have said.
I'll sign a waiver that my child can hear dick jokes. I mean, she lives with me.
I thought it was 16 and over here.
I don't
know.
It is. Oh, it is. So, what did she? She's 15?
No.
Oh, she's.
I'd leave the 15-year-old at home.
She's 17.
She is 17, and she looks older.
You're fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'm almost positive.
Who's walking the door tonight? Do you know?
Probably Ozzy.
I haven't seen Ozzy here in ages.
Well, I saw him
at the airport, by the way.
I saw him the night
midnight.
I was here.
Midnight. I looked homeless.
Yeah.
He's probably like, I'm not letting you in. You look like a homeless person. So you think it's 16 and over. That would be fantastic.
I'm like 99% sure.
I know for our murder mysteries in the Giga Room, it's 16 and over.
I brought Joseph here, but he's 20.
What?
You know, he's
it was a really mean joke that came to my head.
About me?
No.
Go for it. I grew up in the Thomas house.
He's just like way more easy with him.
I am easy.
He is easy.
Kris knows that. How was Amy Schumer?
She's okay.
Just okay?
So I've been an Amy Schumer fan since Last Comic Standing. I've seen her here.
Oh, yeah?
Did you happen to?
No, I've never seen her in person, no.
We saw her here early on, like curly hair early on.
That's when she was really funny.
Really funny.
Yeah.
No filter.
Right.
And I get it. Like, now you're in more of an eye, and like, you can't say things. And
yeah,
I
but
mean,
she's.
I have writers.
Right.
And say it, but true.
Yep.
She was okay. The woman that opened for her, though, oh my God. Please get her here. Can I say that? Do I just speak in the microphone and the gods here listen?
Yes, nobody's watching.
Her name was Mia Jackson, I think. Yeah.
Mia Jackson.
She's
don't
a 6-foot black woman. She didn't even curse that much. This is Mia. Because sometimes
it's like a
like,
worthless detail.
No,
she didn't curse that much.
Well, can I hold her up? Get her here. This woman.
Well.
Here.
Which,
like
oh my God. So funny. So funny.
Pretty.
She,
yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
she was so funny. Mia Jackson opened for her. And I was like, and people weren't in the seats yet or whatever. She was, this woman's talented. She's funny.
Well, forgive me. I don't know who that is.
Well, sometimes don't you find like they're like, I didn't know who this guy was last night. I asked me his name.
Dimitri
again.
Martin?
Yes. No idea.
He's
like a YouTuber.
No. Like that's just it. Like he was, I would say he had actually quote unquote, like one of his peaks would have been in the early 2000s, because like I said, Zach Galifianakis, Dimitri Martin, Patton Oswalt, they were all part of that same generation that came in and were doing sort of an alt what at that time was like an alt comedy, kind of thing.
He's a little out there.
But it's not all comedy compared to like the stupid shit you see in the city now. but because I'm technically along. I would actually put myself not nearly at the same height, but in the same circle of the Venn diagram as those guys. So I've known about Dimitri Martin since late 90s. He had a Comedy Central special when it still meant something to have a Comedy Central special.
So yeah, I find like there are the always. I didn't know about Sebastian Maniscalco until he was selling out the Garden. Like sometimes
oh, yeah, he
people
was here
are more West Coast. Sometimes
yeah,
people
well, he's
are
from
just
Chicago. Yeah,
not my kind of like they don't come in on my radar. And then people mm-hmm. are like, you never heard of this person? I'm like,
oh, that happens to me too. Like and especially like that's about to happen to me for 5 hours because I'm pretty sure Joe Winchell is just gonna the whole ride up to Walton is gonna be telling me how do you not know this person.
You know who I think is, I mean, since this is, there's this guy that plays here. His name is John
Ziegler.
No, that guy's, he's hilarious.
John,
a bunch of others that don't.
His, by the way,
John Rager.
How is he, his benefit was one of the best
oh, yeah.
I've ever been to.
Yep, and he's doing very well. He just put a special out, I think, on YouTube.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, I'm going to watch it.
Yeah.
Yeah, this guy, John Campanelli. Have you seen him here?
I haven't Where's seen him, name? But I know who he is. Yeah. Yeah. I haven't seen him.
He's this guy, like, I'm, you know, because I'm so, I'm who, like, I'm such a fucking judge. But I do feel like I am like what people are for wine. They don't know how to make one. I feel like I am that for, I do.
Well, you
most
do,
people
you,
are.
And you do. You come here a lot.
I do come here a lot. They also send me a lot of free tickets, so that helps. I'm just saying.
I have more for you if you want.
Well, no,
passes.
I just they emailed me that day's
oh.
show.
And
oh, I'm
that's
like,
true.
I'll be
yeah.
there tonight. Mm-hmm. I'll drink two cups of coffee. I don't.
Yeah, true. You get two bottles of water. It counts.
Yeah, my husband will eat, by the way. If I bring Joe, he eats for like five people. It's fine.
Do you ever bring Joe?
I know. He always gets me. Like people. I am married, everyone. And Joe is. People come up to me. Because he, the other night, for example, was like Emerson's Gold Award party. And he had. We are both very active. But we had tickets to, do you know what See Here Now is? It's like that beach festival in Jersey.
No, it happens in Jersey. It doesn't matter.
So it's like a pretty big festival. Last year it was like Pearl Jam and Foo Fighters.
Oh,
so this
cool.
year it was like Stevie Nicks and Green Day with the big headliners. Oh. And I was like, just go. He took my nephew. I was like, just go. And people were like, he's not here. But we've had like three parties for this Gold Award. And then, as a matter of fact, Tuesday is my reception at the library and he's gonna be right. in Vegas like
oh wow
so people will be like or he was like not he didn't live at home when we put the pool in out east like he was work managing that and people like are they I'm like no everything's fine everybody it's fine. As a matter of fact I think the distance helps it but
it could
so Joe
sure.
does come out he was here for the benefit
yes
he'll come to some shows
the nicest guy in the world your husband. Love that guy.
He did just buy me this new iPhone 14 that I love very much. Thank you.
Well, if you do end up doing comedy, it'll be important that he's one of your bringers.
Yeah, true.
What, he's got to bring people?
No, you have to bring people. That's it's sort of the dark underbelly of tri-state area.
I'm just better
comedy.
At drinking the wine instead of making the wine.
You have a great presence. You're funny. You tell a good story. You should definitely take the comedy class and see. Just to see how it goes.
Or even just to like, it might even bring a bigger appreciation because of the amount of comedy you do watch to see what exactly is going on. Because sometimes that's actually a pretty impressive thing.
I think, to see the craft is very interesting for me. I liked watching Last Comic Standing because I think they really, really gave you an idea. And then even if you do watch. Schumer did this documentary about when she was like trying to have a baby or COVID, her kid, and her autistic husband. And, that gave you a lot of insight into her like hammering it out. I love when comics come here and try to do stuff. I could sit here for three. Last time Colin Quinn was here, it was just like legal pad after legal pad.
Yep.
You know, I was talking, last time I was here for the something, I don't know what. But Chris Roach was telling me that he wants to have like legal pad night.
So Chris Roach, I was actually going to bring up Chris Roach at
he
the
did
cheese,
one
at the
I
cheese
think.
Party.
Oh
the
yeah,
cheese show, which is actually weed. It's where they a lot of marijuana. Tim got him on that as the headliner, and he went up there. It was like his first time up since COVID, because it's like in the winter. this last winter, and he went up there with a pad, and he murdered. A lot of the new stuff he's been doing, he was just trying out in front of an audience for the first time.
I would love that. I'd love to watch that.
I would swear. Didn't him and Mick Thomas do a legal pad thing in the Giggle Room? I think they did. Sometime over the summer. It was a Thursday night, and they called it Legal Pad Thursday or something like that. Yeah.
Well, I'd like to see that.
That's every open mic.
I believe, I was here one night, Colin Quinn, for hours. It might have been at the brokerage. It was such a long set, but he was just trying. Even Jim Gaffigan I saw here doing that. He'll try out new stuff. And I'll just sit there and, it's okay. They acknowledge it bombs and then they move on. It's, so great. So great.
So I do have a little 14-second thing that I came up with this morning.
Okay.
And that I'm going to try to work on. I'll explain it after.
The volume might help,
climate deniers. Some of you climate deniers and conspiracy theorists weren't called a worthless piece of shit enough when you were a kid, and it shows.
All right, so the impetus behind that is there's a form of internet meme that is you people haven't been beaten enough and it shows, or you people didn't drink enough coffee and it shows. But this is how people who are like conspiracy theorists, they tend to think that the government wants them for whatever reason. And basically my thought is, well, obviously when you were a kid, nobody told you you didn't matter like they did with me.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm not paranoid, is because nobody gives a shit what I'm doing.
Yeah, I say that about my phone. People are like, but TikTok's going to take your face. I'm like, have at it.
I just heard somebody on Howard Stern where they're like, that DNA thing, I don't want to do the DNA test thing because I think they're going to clone me. Who cares?
Yeah.
Who?
You're not that
interested. It's not me.
That's even with, when somebody takes over your Facebook or they hack you, what are they going to get? First of all, I don't have much, but what are you going to get? Go ahead. Yeah.
Some men just want to watch the world burn. They just want to make it bad.
Well, all right. So we've had a couple of references to your phone.
I love my phone.
Tell us about
the
library show.
Have you seen the new phone?
No.
Oh God.
Just now.
What number are they up to? 14?
I'm up to 14. And you have to update. If you have not updated your phone, update your phone.
Yeah.
You see one of the cool things now with the new 16? Okay. Oh, so look, this is the promo for here today.
Yeah.
So if you, I don't know, is this the camera here?
This one.
Okay. If you hold down on the subject, it takes it out of the picture. Look.
Oh, look at that.
Ooh.
This is not a device. This is an operating system. So your OS 16 update. When I started Doubleday, that's what I did all day, every day, just clipping paths around subjects. And now you can literally with your finger.
Wow.
And then you can copy that and put it in make a meme or put it in a different background. Let's say you want to take out
flowers,
all the people in the back of the beach. Or you just want to put it in a text. Like I could just text you just my outline.
You don't have a newer phone. No, it doesn't work for you.
13, not so much.
That is a fantastic picture of you, by the way.
Peter saying, my friend Peter takes my headshots. Yeah.
So that's a nice segue to the library show.
Yeah, so I teach at libraries, which I really love. I never thought, my mother, when I was young, was like, you should think about being a teacher. I'm like, fucking, I cannot wait to get out of school. You want me to go back? And I really do enjoy it. I teach at libraries, and one of my most popular classes is, I also teach at corporations or companies or even civil groups or whatever, is iPhone photography. How to use your iPhone. People have no clue. And these things, like I said, I started Doubleday when we were shooting film, big film format. And the first digital camera came, and it was like, we spent a fortune, and these phones are better than that. Sometimes I'll shoot things with phone, and people will be, not like gig jobs, but let's say I'm volunteering, and I'm like, I'll just shoot it with the phone, and people will be like, and I'm like, really? Do you have any idea? Especially when we're viewing most every... I will guarantee you that shows, if it's not already happening, shows you're watching now are being shot on an iPhone.
I shot a movie. Me and Billy's movie is our The Legend of Spooky Woods.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the library at Bethpage, which is a I've been able to see a lot of libraries on Long Island, as I'm sure you, and it's crazy. Some of these are amazing. So
a lot of libraries have really
recording me. Is this part of the
No,
he put the stream.
So I can look like I'm thinking when I'm actually reading comments and whatnot.
A lot of libraries have really done a nice job updating their auditoriums and stuff, but Bethpage is one of the nicer ones.
Killer auditorium. They have a 3D printer. They have a laser cutter. They have a lot of great programs. So they have a beautiful gallery in front, and they had asked me, would you like to be our featured artist for September? And I said, well, keeping in line of what I do with this library, let's just feature all iPhone photography.
Cool.
And so it's there now, but Tuesday night I'll probably have some, I'll be there and I'll have some snacks. And if you're not celebrating, I'm sorry, it's Rosh Hashanah. I've already gotten that. Come on down.
Tuesday, what time?
Is it 7 to 8:30?
Okay, so it's Tuesday evening. We know that.
Yeah, it's like a wake. I even made that joke, and the woman did not like it. But they have these benches, and I laid down. I was like, it could be like my wake. Like, everyone could say nice stuff about me. And she was, like, horrified when I said that. But I'd rather have my wake when I'm there, if it helps people.
You'd rather be awake for your
I would. Wake. So I will be there Tuesday. Joe will not. We're not getting divorced. It's just that he's in Vegas with work, not prostitutes. And so he's too cheap. anyway, plus, why go for Salisbury steak when you got filet mignon at home?
Nice.
But yeah, so I'll be there. So come on down. But I do, and I also am teaching classes. So like Floral Park, I'm teaching on the 7th. And if you go to your library and you want that class, you should ask. Because people are always like, I want to come to a class. I'm like, well, just ask your library because then it's good. You know, come down.
All right, so let me ask you about the phone then. And they do take great quality stuff, but
fantastic.
But it has to be really great lighting, no?
Yeah. Well, it captures what you're there. So if the image is poorly lit, it will capture poorly lit. Now, the portrait mode, which is a game changer, does adjust lighting really nicely.
Oh, yeah. But it adjusts it nicely to the point where it's still better than, say, an old 35 millimeter?
An old 35 millimeter? Digital or film?
I'm talking about film.
Well, film only has so much information, right? So when you're shooting a regular film, it only has so much information per, you know, it's a negative, and a negative is this big.
Right.
So did you ever see like a mad world where they blow up a picture?
Love that movie.
Right. So you see when it blows it up, it's like it just winds up being like little dots or cubes.
Yes.
You can only capture so much. So this captures more than that. Yeah.
Really, huh?
Yeah. Now, I will say this. I have done some tests, not with the 14, but with the last, what did I have, whatever I had. And there's another artist I know, and he loaned me this, like, very expensive. I want to say 10. He actually made a movie, like, tens of thousands of dollars. DJI, which is a great company for camera and drones and other type of stuff. They're very expensive at the time equipment, which, like, you know, every year it's like outdated. And I did do a comparison, and I will say that what the phone lacks is low lighting. It's gotten better with the HDR, so it'll shoot HDR, so your shadows you can really open up. But if you're shooting like a movie in low light, so like a haunted house or whatever, more expensive camera really shows the difference there. But again, then you can just adjust your lighting if you're good with lighting. Mm. But like in everyday promos, whatnot, these things are killer, man.
Yeah. Huh?
I mean, your mic is questionable if it's windy, but you could just easily add a mic.
Right.
I've shot
yes.
stuff with Hansma for News 12.
Oh, have you? Yeah.
On not even this phone. So this phone. This new phone, what it has is you can shoot in, do you understand, like, portrait? Have you seen the portrait mode?
So yes.
Oh, yeah.
We're talking
I experimented about, with it for a while.
So it's Andy blurry and sharp, and that gives, like, a more of a professional look.
Yes.
So now you can film that, so your depth of field will change. Without cutting, I can go from you being in focus to then changing where the TV's in focus. Like, there's a really great promo if you check it out. I mean, it's crazy. It's crazy.
It is crazy. And like you said, you know, with Antoinette, you see it sometimes with reporters. They have just their phone or their iPad, and they're doing the whole thing themselves. It's It's a little scary.
I did this whole series of...
What the hell?
That's your lighting where you blacked out the background?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
That one, that's amazing. Yeah, that's,
so you went through all the different lighting modes.
Yeah. I played with it for a little while. But
it's really great.
Then you took pictures.
I also tell people, too, like, it's not just for people. Like, I had a couple people come to my class, and I said, like, does anyone have a, like, Etsy store, online market? It's great for shooting products, if you sell products, if you're a foodie and you have a food blog.
You're doing a lot of dogs?
Oh, my God. I shoot... You know what it is? I just walk around with dog treats in my bag, and I walk a lot. Like, even this morning, I did, like, 3 miles. And I meet dogs, and then I take pictures of dogs. And, yeah.
Ken Bichelle wants to know if you have an Instagram photo account.
Of course.
How do they find it? Because he said he's having trouble finding you because there's a lot of
Christine with a K.
Right.
K-R-I-S-T-I-N-E.
Right. Kris Thomas, Christine Thomas for digital art.
Christine Thomas _. Yeah, because I do a lot of digital art. I do graphics, too. Which I love and I want to do more of. Christine Thomas photo. So Kristine Thomas, Thomas photo, no space. I don't even know if that shows up.
So you have photo and Christine Thomas digital art? Oh, no, that's on Facebook.
Photo _ digital art. But if he gets that far, he'll get to where he's got to go.
Sorry.
Yeah. So that is because I do, I would say, depending on the season, half of my work is like I do the newsletter for Villages. I do, so like shoot it and do their newsletter. I love that. I love
you are nonstop. I'm constantly amazed because I see.
I want to take a nap just listening.
Obviously,
want to take a nap.
Being close friends, I see you on Facebook all the time. I'm like, it's always something.
I feel
like it's
I'll
amazing.
Sleep, but I'm
dead. Yeah, no, I'm not knocking you at all. I think it's fantastic.
So
they
took out half my thyroid last fall. So fucking fun. And so now I'm on whatever, Synthroid, whatever the fake one is. And then they're like, the other day I went to the doctor, and I really pushed to get more. Like, if you're going to put me on stuff, like, let's go to town. And I went to a different doctor the other day, and he's like, but look at your levels. Like, don't you feel hyper all the time? And I'm like, yes, I do. And I was like, I love it. Even my husband will be like, did you take two of those today? Because you're like, a little.
Three. Why do you ask?
So, I'm really like a Jack Russell. Like, I start my day like a Jack Russell. Like, I'm like, what can I do? What class is there? Like, even this morning, like, I had to come a little late because I had to do a little run the Jack Russell few laps.
Wow.
And, but I just love, there's so many great, it all comes out of like love and like I'm interested and I love doing stuff. And it's like, there's just not enough hours in the day.
I hear you.
Like, I love doing what I do, but then I see what other people do and I'm like, oh my God, you do that? I want to do that too. Let's try it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and it's like, that's,
no, that's
like,
the way to do it. Absolutely.
And then it's like, there's stuff you have to do. And then I'm like, oh, I have to make this kitchen look nicer, let's say. And I hate cleaning. So I'm like, I'm going to paint it. So like, I'm painting now. Like, I paint a lot of stuff. I paint a lot.
The breathing break. Right. Probably my favorite part of this entire interview.
Well, as you breathe, I'll read the rest. Ken Bichelle says he found it, and he thanks you.
Yeah, Ken Bichelle, show up. I'm going to try to have cookies.
Well, he lives in North Carolina, but he found the Instagram. His quite amateur photos page is at KJPay _pics.
I'll follow you back.
And he singled you out. He says, follow me, Andy.
So, Andy, follow him.
I missed the pictures of bakeries in the middle of nowhere.
You're right.
he had sent like a bunch of us. He went on a trip. Was that early COVID or post?
I think
right
it was
before, maybe even.
Yeah, it might have been right when it was happening. Yeah.
He and his wife had gone on a trip. He's an Auburn guy. He went to Auburn, and so that's a college in Alabama.
Okay.
And so he was going on this tour, and he took this picture of this bakery, and it's one of my favorite because we all have these things that we're like really into, and we really think everybody else has to know what we're talking about. And he had sent it to all of us and said, guess where I am? I have no fucking clue. I don't know what that is.
Yeah.
So where was he? At a bakery in the middle of nowhere?
At a bakery. And I think it's like famous for some. He's going to probably comment on it. I feel terrible that I don't know. But I was
he took cool photos.
Yes, so they're all very cool photos.
Yeah, it wasn't just like a...
But it was like, guess where I am? And I'm like, right. I'm struggling caring. Yeah. Like, I'm surprised I opened this. Because I usually don't open messages from people.
No, I would open them because the photos, they were good photos of buildings and the skyline and whatnot. So
A couple of churches. The
yeah,
and
right.
Again, like
churches,
on college
yes.
campuses because they were traveling somewhere. And they passed through a couple of big, what was the one? Baylor. They stopped on Baylor. They were in Waco.
I was just about to say that. The bakery was in Waco.
Texas.
Yeah.
And then he says it was
Magnolia
the
in Waco. Do you know this bakery?
I know Magnolia. Of course.
Okay, well, there you go.
I like to eat dessert a lot.
You should have sent it to her. Ken sent her pictures.
Ken, this is what I will say when I hear you say, like, my quite amateur page. I was not, my background is not photography. I was a retoucher and a graphic artist.
I would go for just you being a toucher.
I touched again and again and again. And I would do these jobs, and then the professional photographer would provide crap. And I'd be like, I'm just going to shoot this myself, okay? And they'd be like, can you just kind of be our photographer now, like for things? And so I think that I am a big believer. This sounds like, I do think some kids are told they could be whatever they want, but you can be. I really
That's not true.
Like, did you ever meet someone you're like, this is the fucking vice president? Or like,
yes.
Like politicians. Yeah. Like, I have told friends, like, just run for office. You'll be in Congress in like no time. And they're like, no, not me. And I'm like, have you met it? I'm sure you, I'm not saying they're bad. I'm just saying you're good. Like, you can run for office. Like,
nah, there's way too many pictures of me doing stuff.
But it, like, you can, like, There's a very fine and barely a line between amateur and professional. Like, you just need a couple bucks to be professional. And it's like there are people out there who for all these different reasons think they're not a professional, and then all these other people who think they're professional. Shit. I mean, Jackson Pollock has multiple walls at MoMA. That's all I'm saying. So, like, you know.
So my brother and I, if very rare now that we're old and we have families, but we would go to MoMA when we were younger and stare at blank walls, just sit there and go, and see how many people we could get to also look.
And they probably did.
Oh God. Yeah. We would get early Fratelli brothers. Yeah. You could barely see brush strokes. I'm sure there was a roller used here, maybe on an angle. Like, we would have these whole conversations about stuff like that.
I mean, Jackson Pollock fooled everyone.
Yeah.
And made a fortune doing it.
Right.
And then if you ever see Lee Krasner's work,
nope.
Who picked his shit up, I'm sure cleaned his vomit up. She was his wife who had to deal with his drunk ass.
Oh, is that the guy that destroyed everything?
He splatter paint, Pollock, oh, okay. Jackson Pollock. Okay. And he was married to Lee Krasner, who he
No, no, that's
up.
What I'm talking about. Lee Krasner. Oh, I know okay. Jackson Pollock.
No, she was his wife.
Chief. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And she was like this really, in my opinion,
right.
We know I'm all about my opinions. Her stuff is really good, but she had to take a fucking back seat. And she's probably like, no, I dabble, but Jackson's the fuck artist in the house. And it's like, go see her work. And it's like, she was someone who was saying like, well, I'm the amateur. He's the professional. It's all...
Like just, Yoko and John.
It's bullshit. Oh, God. No. But like, you know, so don't... You keep going there.
Well, it's funny that Kent, finally, I had no clue. Maybe I missed it in that group message, that it was a reflection of the Magnolia silos in the church's window. I'm like, what fucking church is this? I'm going
Bring
on Google
on
Maps.
Come on.
I was going on Google Maps, like, being like, what is the significance of this fucking place? Like, okay, I get the bakery is apparently some sort of famous bakery, but I was like, I was on the toilet, and I was like, I'm like, trying to get in as close as pot. Like, I don't get, like... And then I'm, like, Googling the name of the church. I mean, this is a couple of years ago, so I don't remember any of it. But I was, like, trying to figure out.
Yes, you put a lot of thought into things. I'm just like, oh, that's a nice picture.
I was pooping.
Well, true. You have the time. Right.
Okay. I've had children in less time than it takes some men. I'm just saying.
Yeah. No,
human beings have come out of me.
Less time than it takes us to poop?
I'm just putting it out there.
I'm with you. I'm a long pooper.
Okay. Yeah.
It takes me a while. Yeah. I'm no argument.
You're not insulting anybody.
Okay. I'm just saying. I produce life. He's got a lot of pictures, so I will look for your Magnolia picture and then. But I do know Magnolia.
I wonder if I can pull it up, actually.
Fender says he just pooped.
Fender's got things wrong with his ass anyway. So.
Well,
right? Isn't that what you keep on getting?
Well, that's
operations
right. He's been getting surgery on his ass, yeah. So that's Bethpage Library.
Yeah.
It's playing. Now, if you can't make it Tuesday, you can still go to the exhibit. It's there until the end of the month.
Correct. I think I'm going to take it down on the 29th. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Take down library on my calendar because I have something on the 30th. But, yeah,
that's
it was.
Bethpage Library.
Just, yeah, I mean, you'll see the bio, but everything shot on your iPhone. There's this amazing photographer on the North Fork. He's called, his name's Chris, but he's like the fisherman's son or whatever is his handle. And, like, did covers of, and I'm not saying, like, oh, it's Vogue, but, like, the North Forker magazine's a pretty nice publication.
Yeah.
He's done covers, and he's had an exhibit at the library out there, and I bumped into him because he sells his prints on the street if you're ever out there, and shoots with an iPhone.
Shit's amazing.
Great. Shit's great. It's not, it's like saying, like, there are people who can do sculptures with, you know, like a knitting needle. Oh, yeah, he likes the reflection. But that's a bakery?
Yeah, I'll show you the bakery picture here. It should be the next one.
When you're shooting with an iPhone, like, because you said your background's not photography, so.
Yeah.
Like, I've seen, you know, a lot of photographers, you know, they'll try to really, you know, just get it a certain angle or a certain lighting, and you know, they try to really envision what. Is it still the same with the iPhone, too, or yeah. It's just a different.
Or you get to play around with it afterwards. Like
I play around
it.
Both, though.
Mm-hmm.
But the in-app, so my show, everything at my show, nothing went into Photoshop. Everything was edited within the camera edits, which you can do incredible. Shoot HDR, people.
Mm-hmm.
I know it's bigger. Just put your shit in the iCloud. Don't worry about your storage. And then shoot HDR, and you can do so much. Like you can adjust your light balance and don't worry about your shadows and, you know, you want underexposed. You should really all take my class. But really, it's free. It's a free class, by the way. I'm not
trying
to sell
you anything. When is that?
But I could go. My next one is November 7th in Floral Park. But if you go to your library, just be like, Chris, you know.
Yeah, so it's not like a series of classes. It's a library. You can go one night for what, like 2 hours? And then you go to a different library?
I'm
it's not like.
I'm just going
to
adjust because I'm getting comfy.
She was going to swing at me.
Yep, she was going to punch you.
Yeah, so I say I'm going to only work for an hour, but these people come up to me and they have all these questions, and I'm like, I really do enjoy it, so I'll sit there for hours. They kick me out of the library.
Right, but it's not like a six-week commitment to take a class or anything. It's just it's one night, go to this library, go to that library.
If they like me, they bring me back for like 2.0, mm-hmm. Which I've done.
Right.
Or I'm thinking of actually doing a class because a lot of people... you know, because I'm pretty savvy and my husband's, you know, I sleep with the IT guy. A lot of people come up to me with, yes, I have great Wi-Fi. a lot of people come up
he
to me
also. Gives good Wi-Fi?
Yes.
Nice.
Two routers.
A lot of men don't.
And a booster.
A lot of men are incapable of delivering that kind of Wi-Fi.
My house is crazy.
Nice.
Like, especially if they're seniors, they come up and they're like, well, how do you block? Like, so my next class I think I'm putting together is also like just basic scams. And because I do a few classes,
idea.
I do like how to get a good headshot, how to get a good family photo so you could shoot your own stuff. I do the iPhone's my most popular. I've done like internet safety. So like I did that once and people like, I can see how
my mother goes
hacked.
To those at the Comsawag Library.
Oh, I've taught there.
Oh, okay. That my
she was there. That
I
was
betcha.
My class.
So literally, like, I just want to put stuff on the Facebook.
Wait,
she was the
sure
one complaining about
how long ago was this?
Within the past 3 months, maybe 3 months ago.
She that might
one,
not be it.
She was the one complaining about her son. How much she just can't stand
well,
him.
There was a guy who was like
him and his mustache.
He made two Facebook. He was a realtor. So think about how much he could do free advertising in real estate and the turnaround and everything. And he made two accounts. He didn't even know.
Now, what about... Well, right. That's the thing. So you talk about, you know, older folks who don't even know they made two accounts. They also don't have... usually, I'm being an ageist, they usually don't have the latest technology either.
True.
So how do you...
I'll sit there and update their stuff or I'll tell them how to do it later.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, they need to.
I would think that takes a lot of time, though, away from the class to explain that stuff to them.
So even in Bethpage, she said, you know what, you really are very hands-on. I think next class, because they have this beautiful auditorium. She's like, I think I'm going to do it in a conference room so you can really go up to everybody. Because they, yeah, because when you teach someone, too, you really don't want to do it for them. You want to, like, walk
right.
them through it.
Right.
That's why I'm there for 2 hours. But, like, you're helping these people. Like, where am I going?
So we can make this special needs thing work then, right?
Yes. But can we not get those iPads?
Yeah, those iPads are old and prehistoric. With the PEL, the special needs PEL,
I'm trying to imagine what a prehistoric iPad would look like.
Well, it looks like an iPad, but old iPad.
I'm talking about that. I know you're.
So we had found them in our building. We don't know where they. Well, we have ideas of where they possibly came from, but there was, I think,
it fell off a truck.
Yeah, exactly. There was like 12 or 13 of them.
Yeah.
So we're like, well, so what do we do with these? So I said, well, I have a friend who teaches a class. Why don't we? We'll set these iPads up, give them to the participants, and Kris will teach the class. And then, these things were just too much. They were too
better
hard.
Better frisbees than anything.
Yeah. So we kind of killed the idea, but because I was thinking we'd have to buy new iPads, but we don't have to buy new iPads.
Who uses an iPad? Do you really use an iPad?
I got for my
10-year-old daughter had. For her birthday, we got her an iPad mini.
But you're right. Most people are using their phones for this stuff now.
It's shut her up and about asking
those,
for a phone.
And those things are slowly getting bigger and bigger.
Mine's
anyway.
Pretty big.
Yeah. So is mine. But that's because you're here.
Mine just works really good. Really, really good at working. That's it. Everybody tells me anyway.
So, all right. But yeah, we can still get that class going. Then they just bring their own phones.
Yes.
All right. See, I didn't even think about that. That's how stupid I am. I didn't even think. Oh,
they can
just
do
use
so
their own
much
phones.
On their phone. All right. I mean, I'm even put this now, together. I feel like, I had a girl. She doesn't really know what she wants to go to college for. But her parents came to me. I'm also like I am my father's daughter. Like, I know a guy. Like, I always know someone.
Father knew everybody. Your brother, too, knew everybody.
He knew everyone, right?
Everybody.
So people come to me now, and they're like, you know, my daughter, she needs volunteer hours. And I'll be like, no. Okay. Your daughter is 16. She's going to get an internship, and it's going to be legit. And then when she applies for college, like, that's way better than volunteer hours. And it'll be... And then I know the woman that runs this charity, and she comes to me, and she's like, you know, I help them out a little bit. I can't make it my job. Like, I can only do so much. So I'm like, I put these two people together, because generally charities are run by, like, middle-aged people or older.
Right.
And social media is, like, free advertising, and
right.
not-for-profits have no money.
Right.
So, and kids need not volunteer hours.
So social media.
So this young girl.
Smart.
I put her together with this, it's like Olivia Osman Hearing Foundation. They do great stuff. Did you know that hearing aids are not covered by insurance? What a hunk of shit. Well, if your limp dick is covered by insurance, a kid should be able to hear. Not saying you're a limp dick or you're a limp dick. I'm just saying it's complete bullshit.
My limp dick is more important than my hearing.
Yeah, I would much rather have
a choice, but a child should get their fucking hearing aid paid for. Okay.
No. If all the children could not hear anymore, but my penis works correctly, I'm fine with that. Go on. I'm sorry. But point
they
taken.
They need help, social right. media. And this young woman now has this great, they love her. It's a great relationship. Right. She's love. And it's like, so you have, this is a market where in industry, you don't have to wait for people to retire and people to move out of the way. The kids can take this over. So when you have, if you're bringing me like young men and women that are about to enter, this is a great market for them.
Yeah,
they don't have to commute. You can do everything from your home.
Sounds like a cult.
Yes, and we'll be
it's like offering. Kool-Aid. You're offering up young men and women.
No, but they should, like, this is a great industry.
No, you're absolutely right.
And they should be savvy with this, because it's like the middle-agers aren't learning it. You should see when I mentioned TikTok, they're like, what?
The tickety-tackety?
TikTok's fantastic.
I got a TikTok.
TikTok is fantastic?
I love TikTok.
Really?
Prove me wrong.
I don't have to prove you wrong. I'm
on
TikTok, but I don't like it. It's too quick.
Oh, well, I'm running around like a bullet, and I'm on a double med, so...
You have a couple of what you're on? Like, well,
I enjoy a good, you know, something with a plot and takes its time to, you know, and is a little smarter.
Are we talking about porn? Like...
Oh, you want to talk about porn?
Is
sure.
Is that what it sounds like? I mean, you need a plot for what?
Well, I mean, the situation has to be... like plausible, like you know, like, oh, she's my stepdaughter, but she's got all these tattoos. That's weird. Right. Like, I definitely want like a tattoo list stepdaughter.
But I
think we're not still talking about porn, are we? I just realized.
I can hold my own.
I'm really sorry. Keep going.
But
I don't think you want to with me.
But I wouldn't go to TikTok for porn. It just sounded like when you said you needed a plot that we were.
Well, no, because people go on TikTok and they'll do something mindless and silly, and 30 seconds later it's over. I'm like, what the hell was that? I like
so it's like regular. Porn. Sounds like regular sex, not porn.
But no, I don't. I think you need to control your search then. So, like, what are you interested in, and then make TikTok work for you. Right now, you're working for TikTok, right? You want TikTok to work for you. So the algorithm is when you start searching for stuff and what you like and follow, it will give you more of that.
Are you on Twitch?
You know what? I'm not, but I tried to download it, and I was out and about, and I wanted to wait, so I'm not on Twitch.
Well,
but I heard
you have. That's where we're on today.
I know. I did.
I actually downloaded it yesterday on my TV.
Oh.
Wow. So. Look at you.
Smart TV.
Well, now you can give technology classes. How to get Twitch on the TV.
Yeah. I just
airdrop everything from my phone. That's not.
That's what I do,
yeah.
But the thing is I want to use my phone for everything else while it's so.
It can airdrop while I'm emailing.
If I'm watching something, typically because I have to keep that open, like whatever I'm watching.
I can just slide to a different window. I have success with that.
I've not.
Ken Pichel says, "Can't wait for the day
when I play with it all the time."
See all my windows open.
Ken Pichel says, "Can't wait for the day when Andy's." Teenage daughter says, "Mom, have you heard Dad on KDC? He's the best."
Yeah. No, they'll think. Well, they've been here.
They have been here. Well, yes.
Ken, like that.
Yeah, but they don't watch. Maybe he didn't. But they don't watch when they're here.
Greatest moment ever. Jackie the Joke Man Martling is in here. My daughters are there, and one of them's more of a character. She's the 8-year-old, and they've had headphones on devices like the entire time. Not that they didn't have anything else available to them, but Jackie gets up and he's like, "Girls."
Yeah, when it was over, when we were leaving.
We're done,
yeah.
Cameras off, everything. Girl, you gonna miss me? And Daphne just kind of looks up at him like this.
Good for her.
Just pulls him up.
Tell me how you really feel, Daphne.
It was great.
So what, you talked in front of them candidly? Or you
I talk to them almost all the time, but they also have their earphones. They don't even want to hear. They don't want to listen. But I'm a very strong believer in that words are important. All words matter, but that they learn to use them in the appropriate places, and that they should never hear anything somewhere else for the first time. Because one of the things I hate is being out in the world and somebody surprising me with something. Mm. So language is not something to be surprised by or to be like affected you because. People bluntly use like curse words particularly, or they get loud or to throw you off. And so, no, I'm teaching my kids to be like, cool. Like, okay, great. You're yelling. Oh, great. You cursed. I can say fuck, shit, dick, motherfucker too. Like, what are you actually saying? What are we actually talking about? Because that was the whole, can we go to the bathroom versus may we go to the bathroom?
Yes. Oh, I thought you were just commenting that.
No, I had the conversation last night and I gave them the argument to make the next time they get into that situation with their teachers of being like, listen, I'm not asking you if I can actually physically go to the bathroom. I'm asking because you're using go to the bathroom as the verb. I'm just using go. The destination is the bathroom. So no, you have to give me permission to go. So can I go?
Right.
It is completely appropriate and proper.
Yeah.
May is this bullshit like, may I? Like that you, like you're forcing me to put you at a higher pedestal than I already am, which you're a teacher. I'm calling you Mrs. Whatever. I shouldn't have to then go even further like, oh, great and wonderful teacher in front of me. Would you be so kind as to allow me to travel to the place where I can urinate and defecate. And I gave them those words to, as I said, like the more words you know, the more situations you can like totally flip on people.
Yeah.
Because like say, shit, defecate. Sometimes defecate is the much better word to use. And not because you're trying to be polite, but because you're trying to, it can be more cutting in certain situations.
Yeah.
So
there's a, you know, argument can be an art.
Right.
I always say,
oh, yeah, Brian, absolutely.
As big as Brian was,
yep,
he could, let's say someone in a group situation was acting like an a-hole, waiting in line, let's say they try to cut the line. Brian could have easily picked them up, really, but yeah, with one hand, and
yep,
right, them. He was, like, massive.
Yep.
But he had this art where he could, like...
Well, this is the... I'll say the tradition of the Irish. As I'm gonna guess this is... You would say the same thing. Because you're talking about... Yeah. Are you talking about your...
Yeah, my brother.
Brother. So
he could, like, make a fool of the laugh... But we all leave laughing, like, you don't carry that anger with you going right home. Where if I'm getting in a verbal argument with someone, I go home and I'm, like, pissed. It's an art, and I always admire that, and I try to, like, do that.
There's that Irish blessing, because you keep saying about your dad was the Irish one out of the family?
Yes.
So is that the tradition of the oral whatever, like where you're trying, the blessing is... Being Irish, it means being able to tell somebody that to go to hell so much, yeah, so that they look forward to the trip.
Yeah.
That, like that.
Right. That's good. I never heard that.
Don't say, like, you don't have to go straight at people. Like, sometimes, you know, it's the, you know, sugar catches flies better than vinegar or honey.
Like a grin fuck, sometimes people say. It's a grin fuck. But he would get everyone laughing. The haven't person would feel like an asshole, but wouldn't be in a confrontation with Brian.
Where they save face. Yeah.
Because Yeah. And it was like, so I'd like to get better at that.
The more the more vocabulary you have, the better you understand about things like straw man arguments and ad hominem arguments. Like, that's why I said, like, if anybody ever say something to somebody and they insult you, recognize that they've insulted you and acknowledge it to them. Like, okay, you can feel about me all you like. The point I'm making, though, is true. And that's why you're trying to take a shot at me. Like, that's how we work in the Pleganos household.
And I have to say, TikTok, to bring this back to TikTok, they have so many great, like, little snippets of, like, how to deal with psychological tricks and tips, how to de-escalate a situation.
Right, yeah, you're right.
If a bully comes up to you and says, like, oh, my God, like, you have no chest. Yeah, I have no chest. Like, yeah, that's great. Great observation. What are you going to do about it?
I don't believe that. Hang on.
Well, I'm just saying, like, anything, yeah, like, no, acknowledge it.
Turn the cameras off. If that's going to make you comfortable. We'll turn the heat up if you'd like as well.
I have been to several new beaches this week. But, like, they just say, like, yeah, okay, and then just be like, or even you can, like, really de-escalate and be like, I'm sorry, what did you say? Make them repeat it. Like, all these little tips for all of us to navigate the world. And I also, I'm like, I'm not the biggest person in the room. And it does sometimes when there's the biggest, most strongest person in the room uses that for evil. That's like,
right,
it drives me bananas, especially in this climate we have. So in addition to all of my carry permits, I try to, like, learn. I'm racking them up. I try to, like, learn things like that.
I just had them. We were talking about dealing with somebody who's saying something that doesn't make any sense or is a stupid thing to say, is to say what? And just repeat yourself, what?
Yeah.
And then at some point when you do actually, because sometimes you don't understand what they're saying. And so keep asking what until you do understand. And then at that point when you recognize that it's a stupid thing to be saying, say, I'm sorry, I can't hear stupidity, or I can't hear bullshit.
Yeah.
So you're going to either have to become smarter or shut up.
Yeah. It's usually the latter.
Yeah.
Yep. And speaking of which, it is time for us to shut up.
Oh, we're shutting up?
Yeah.
Joe's filming a podcast the whole ride, 5 hours. I don't think the whole time.
Yeah. Have a great time this weekend.
I will. I won't die, Tony.
All right.
Well,
have fun in Walton. What are you doing up there?
Not
that you
drugs.
Might die?
Well, because he's going with a bunch of comedians. They're performing. They were going to take mushrooms with them.
Oh.
And that, so I was worried about Andy, but they've killed the whole mushroom plan.
Oh, they haven't. Well, Jay's not going to be with us.
Yeah, Jay's had to cancel.
Billy Guyer, Joe Winchell, Terry McNeely. Was supposed to also be Fat Jay, but he had a death in the family.
Our condolences to Jay.
It's happening quite a rash.
Yeah, I had a funeral yesterday. It was a rough one. Yeah. So all our best to Jay. Ken Pichelle says, behave yourself.
That'll be a funny car ride. Right, mushrooms or no mushrooms?
Yeah, absolutely. A bunch of comedians. Yeah, there's going to be, and they're all good guys, so it'll be a lot of fun.
Yeah, no. This is going to be a good time.
All right, and don't forget Tuesday. Head on over to the Bethpage Library.
Yeah.
And then check out the fantastic work by the very talented Kris Thomas. And what was it? Floral Park Library in November.
November's maybe first. I'll be at the Floral Park Library. But again, like, ask your local library if you want me to come and do travel. I also am a fan of working out east as much as possible because that's where I want to live. November 1st, I will be at the Floral Park Library teaching iPhone classes.
And speaking of November, pal.
November 15th.
The Knockem Dead Comedy Radio Show, brought to you by 15th, Two Eagles Auto Body. Oh, for more than 25 years, Two Eagles Auto Body has been the leader in auto body repair.
Okay, so it looks
How
like
old
some...
How will you be?
47.
Nice. It looks like sometime in November is going to be the premiere of Comic Sans.
Oh,
a movie that a movie that Andy's in.
Oh. And Tony.
Yes, I'm in it too.
Where will you be premiering it?
Well, we have a place in mind. I've been in conversations with them, but it's not set. You know, it's that the Belmore Movie Theater, the one house, not the big one down the block. We've been in discussions with them. Yeah, there's the poster there.
Oh, loved. Very cool. Malvern lets you rent it out.
It's actually the same people that run Malvern and Belmore. But yeah, I think we're going to do Belmore. But we're still ironing out the details. But we have a possibility for a date in November. So we're very excited for that. Like I told you guys earlier this week, we're going to give out some free passes to come see that movie when we premiere it in November. So,
We'll keep you updated. People to people's houses to force them to come.
So, we'll keep you updated on that.
Hilarious, though.
And don't forget, like I said earlier, Craig Robinson, Liz Mealy, Medium Robert Hansen, Tom Eshelman, or Mike Fenoya, all playing at various governor's places this weekend. So go to govs.com and make your reservation to some great comedy. Including
and Olga. Let's not forget Olga.
Well, Olga's
she's
always here. You'll see her.
I have to sing her praises. She's funny. I don't want to ruin it, but one of her jokes, man, gets me giggling every time.
She's great.
She's come a long way.
Friday, November 18th, in the Giga Room, Hershey and the Keegs are doing their first Hershey and the Keegs show. It's going to be great, so don't miss out on that. Carl is a part of it. Fat Jay is there, so that's going to be fun. Don't miss that. Go to govs.com to make your reservations. All these great comedy shows.
Port Jefferson Station's own Tom McGuire and Long Island Laugh Off 2021 winner, Tom McGuire.
Very nice.
I just have to say, I mean, I'm sure these people are already signed up, but if you don't... You should get the emails from governors.
Yes, get on their mailing list. They'll send you codes to get in. To get free admission.
Or early, like sometimes if dirty every pictures. Now and then, remember, like big headliners come.
Right.
And if you don't have that email and that code, that's
right.
So Jim Gaffigan and Colin Quinn and stuff. Yeah.
Kevin James comes through a lot. Louis C.K. Don't forget Friday, October 28th, the murder mystery with Knockem Dead Comedy, just in time for Halloween with a murder, a costume contest. It's going to be a lot of fun. So, here in the Giga Room.
Wow. Hopefully Friday, we'll October 28th. Get a real murder in there.
That's right. We're going to kill. Ha ha, get it? We're going to kill. Let's see. Do I have any other? I did that one. Just making sure I don't have any other things to announce. Okay. I think that is it. That's it. And don't forget tonight here on Gov's Comedy Club podcast on the YouTube channel. Don Sill will be talking to Jamie Kennedy.
That's cool as hell.
Yeah, it is very cool.
We were just talking about Jamie Kennedy the other day. Great guy.
Yeah, they had a great interview. You're going to really enjoy it. Don talking to Jamie Kennedy. That's tonight at 8 o'clock on Gov's Comedy Club Podcast YouTube channel. So right now we're the only show on the Twitch channel, but yeah, we're working on that. We're going to get all the shows here eventually. So yeah, lots of stuff going on. So everybody have a great weekend. There's no Green Room show this weekend, so enjoy Don tonight with Jamie Kennedy, and then we'll be back here. Oh, guess who's with me in here on Monday?
No, tell me.
No. One of your favorites? You know who I'm talking about.
No, I don't, because with the whole conversation we had before this. I don't know if you're just fucking
Mike with me. Kaplan will be sitting in here with me on Monday.
Fuck that guy.
You don't know him,
thank God. Don't get to know him. Watch, so you can know who he is and how to avoid him.
That'll be Monday. Everybody have a great weekend. Thank you, Kris Thomas, for hanging out. As always, always a lot of fun. Thank you, pal.
Thank you.
Looking forward to next Friday, hearing your stories from this weekend.
If I'm still alive.
I was worried you'd either not be alive or you'd just like...
Disconnect from reality?
Yes, you would like
That's
become
what I'm
like...
shooting for.
You would like find religion or something and then be a different man.
No such thing.
Somebody just waved to me. I don't know who it was. I couldn't really see. All right, everybody have a great weekend and we'll see you Monday. See ya.